What's up, guys? Welcome back to Maestro Vapes. Today we're going to be building a 22 gauge parallel coil. Check it out. If you've got some weak ass batteries, some 10 amp batteries or 15 amp batteries, don't do this build. Make sure you're using like a VTC5, EFES 35 amp, something that can handle the amp drain on this build, okay? It's going to come in at 0.09 ohms. Let's build it, shall we? All right, so we're building a 22 gauge parallel coil. Today we're gonna need, I like to use a long piece of 22 gauge. I've got about, you know, a foot, 14 to 16 inches worth here, 22 gauge canthal. We're gonna need a 2.4 millimeter screwdriver to wrap around. You're gonna need something to squeeze those coils together, so we're gonna be using some pliers. You're also gonna need something to cut this thing with. I've got these little cutters that you can get at your local hardware store. We're gonna be wicking it with cotton. I'm gonna be building this on the Patriot Clone 3 post Addy, all right? So let's get into it, shall we? So the first thing that we're gonna need to do here is put a fold into our piece of canthal so that we can parallel coil this. I just grabbed the ends here, split it into half, or somewhere near half anyway, and get a little fold in there, and then I squinch it together with my pliers. You don't have to kill this here, but you know, give it a good squeeze so that it's sitting right beside one another, okay? Then you wanna try and keep this thing together, even it out if you have to. I'm just gonna put a little bend in this. Oh, it's kinda hard to do this behind a camera, but whatever, that's the story of my life here. Bend that out. Starting to cross over on itself and I'm all over the place. You want to get these lining up fairly nice to one another so that you can get even wraps. It's looking fairly close. We can work with this. All right. So grab our wrapping device. We are using the 2.4 millimeter screwdriver. You just want to keep this side by side. Start making your wraps here. I'm going to leave about an inch, a nice hefty little bit to wrap around. .22 is a little tough to get started. I'm gonna give this a little yank. As it folds over on itself, fix that up. We keep wrapping. And we're gonna shoot for 5 wraps on this. It's the third one. And the fourth one. One more. Oh, it's starting to wrap on top of itself. That's okay. You can pull that back and fix it up. There we go. Now, if your wraps are a little bit off, you can tug on this guy. So just grab both of your ends or one end at a time and just give them a yank. So I'll grab it up, give that a pull. Hear my watch rattle. Same thing with the other leg. I should have really taken my watch off for this. All right, so that's what it's gonna look like when you got it all wrapped up. Now we can put it through our post holes on our Addy and wrap it on the other side. Now I'm just gonna try and keep these wires in the same parallel setup, I guess. Line that up and get it going through those holes. There she blows. If you need a little bit of assistance pulling this through, you can use your pliers. The holes on the Patriot clone are pretty sufficient for building this, but it is gonna need a tiny yank here, just a wee bit of help. Come on there, buddy. Come on there, buddy. I'm just pushing it to the center a little bit here. There we go. Now I could tighten down my center positive. Once I got that fairly tight, I can push this in just a little bit further. There we go. Now we can dial in our negative. I'm going way off camera here. All right, let's check the resistance on this and see what it's coming in at right now. So we're coming in at 0.19, which is going to be excellent. Well, let's just give this a little fire and we'll squish those coils together a little bit. All right, make sure your leads aren't touching the base of the deck or anything else for that matter, so you don't get any shorts. Just heat that up. Give it a little pinch. I'm just gonna check my my connections here, make sure they're snug still. Because they could back out on you. Oh, there we go. Just gonna give that a light pinch. And that's heating up nice and even, okay? Now I'm gonna clip this lead right here. Because that's just gonna be in our way. All right, get our lock switch on. And I'm just gonna start wrapping this from the other side. So I like to take this and just kind of push it over a little bit. It's my first time using these screwdrivers, so hopefully this goes well. Although I kind of want to grab my my old trusty one. Just trying to keep these wires parallel still. Now when you're wrapping this side, you're gonna need to use your pliers to give that a yank and line your coils up. Same thing, put another wrap in there. Sorry, I just had to pull that off camera just to straighten up the leads. I had to pull it into my chest and give it a yank. I might have to do the same thing on this one. And I'm going to try not to. It's a lot easier to do this if you get each individual wrap looking really nice and then, you know, not have to mess around with it at the end. Make sure you don't get your legs crossed up like I'm doing right now. Come on, buddy. There we go. I think that's gonna work out. I'm hoping that's gonna work out. Well, if not, I can always take it back. Let's take a look at that. Is that wrapping the right way? Or is that crossing? Oh, that looks right. All right. Ounce of prevention, friends. Same thing. Try and pull those into place. Once again, I'm going to have to pull this up to my chest. Alright, so I'm back from tugging this thing towards my chest for a little while. So far, that's what we got. We got 5 wraps on this side, 4 wraps on this one. So now that we're going for our 5th wrap, we're just going to wrap it all the way around and then pull it through our post holes. I like to have a generous amount of wire when I do this. You might not, you know? You don't have to use this much wire. Okay. But my wires are overlapping because, you know what? Building is not perfect. Building is difficult. You know, it's not easy. If it was easy, everyone would build 22 gauge parallel coils and rock them out super hard. But it's not, you know? So now I've got this kind of mess of wires that I've been yanking and tugging on. It's not really even. So this is a good time to kind of try and get them staying together. I'm going to clip a little bit of this wire off because I got tons going on right now. So just going to give it a snip right there. Take those pieces off. And this should be enough that I can wrap it. I'm going to put a small fold in here. Just kind of put a curve into it. So that I can get it through those holes and yank it through. Once again, I'm probably gonna have to pull this off camera, but all I'm doing is keeping these wires parallel and trying to get them in that hole. So I'm just gonna line them up and then I'll come right back. All right, so I've got the wires pushed through. I had to fiddle with it. It helps if you have really strong fingers to kind of mash this 22 gauge wire through because it is pretty tough to work with, okay? So now that I've got that, I've got kind of a shorter lead here. Just gonna try and bring that in a bit and kind of line those two up. They are running through that post hole perfectly parallel. So now if I just grab both of these give them a yank, it should work out. Does it all the time? Not necessarily. Hopefully in this case, it does. Okay, so give them a good pull. Then I like to pull each individual lead and just get them nice and tight. That's what you want with this coil. Nice and tight, or else you're gonna get little high spots, hot spots, and you don't want that, okay? So we got that dialed in to where we want it. Just gonna pull it away from the positive post a little bit, just to give it a little bit of room to breathe, a little bit of wiggle room. And then I'm gonna hit it up from the other side. And what I'm gonna do is, same thing as the other one, I'm just gonna push it towards the center post a little bit, because we don't want it to hit your top cap as it's firing, because there are a lot of wraps on this. 5 wraps becomes 10. Okay, I'm just trying to pull that forward a bit on that positive post, and now I can tighten this sucker down. Down, 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 down. Tighten her down. I always sing in my videos. Such a freak show. Freak! Alright, so got that in there. Saying it's pretty good. I'm gonna be pretty happy with this. I can just tug that over. Alright, let's check what the resistance is right now before we start firing it. And then I'm just gonna cut those leads off and come back, and we're gonna dry fire this a little bit. Alright. Okay, so it comes in at 0.09. So if you're running this coil, you want to make sure you have a 35 amp battery, something like that, that can handle the drain, the amp drain that this is going to put on it. All right. So I'm going to take it out. I'm just going to cut that lead off, check it out, make sure it's okay. All right. So I switched mods, went to the Copper Nemesis. All I did was clip that one wire and make sure that my posts were tightened down all the way. Let's give it a little fire, shall we, and see how she heats up. That's the one we already fired. This is the one we're gonna need to pinch up a little bit. Getting there, woo, little popple. Might have a slight shart in there. Double check all this. All right, I'm digging that. So it's firing pretty nicely. Wait for this to cool a little bit, wick it up with some cotton, show you the method that I use for wicking. So I take a cotton ball and then I start to unravel it. I find where the end is, just unravel it. I try and keep my cotton as fluffy as I possibly can, just so that the airflow is a little bit better. All right, then I'll take this guy and I'll usually rip it. If I'm doing a 2.4 millimeter screwdriver, I'll probably take just about a third, maybe slightly more than a third, and just pull that piece off. All right. And I can already feel that this is pretty consistent. There's no real bumps or lumps in here, but if you do have some chunks in there, then kind of roll it out. You can tug it out a little bit just to make sure it's really nice and consistent. Okay. Same thing on this end. Kind of floof it out. All right. Now I'm just going to put a little twisty in this side. and we can wick this bad boy up. Make sure this guy's locked. It should be cooled down enough by now. Put that in through. Give it a little pull. You can kind of twist this up if you want. Tighten it up a little bit. Should be pulling through your coil fairly easily. There should be some resistance, but not a ton. You don't want your airflow restricted too much. Now, I'm going to leave a bunch on here. Just going to rip a piece off, and then I'm going to wick the other side just the same way. So now I'm just going to do the same thing. Put a little twist in this side. Just enough that I can push through that coil. And we'll go in the exact same way we did the other one. That should go through. It should go through. That should not go through. There we go. Same thing, give that a tug through. You can give it a little bit of a twist, give it a little bit of help going in there. A little snug there. We don't want that. I'm just gonna pull it till I find a spot that I like. It's starting to rip a bit. It's not good. I'll try and get past that spot. And find a little fluffy, nice little spot here. All right, this thing is gonna cook super hot. So what I do is, I just take my nice fluffy cotton, grab some tweezers, something to kind of push this underneath here with, and I put a ton of cotton in here. Once you saturate this up with e-liquid, it's actually not going to look as puffy as it is right now. Get that under there. Then I give that a little pull. Still try and keep that a little floofy. Turn it over. Do the same thing on this side. Just going to push that underneath that coil. I actually pushed my coils fairly low, so it's kind of a pain to wick this right now. There we go. Give that a little yank. Just leave a little bit right there. And then I'm going to take some scissors, which I didn't get prepared. And I'm just going to snip off any excess here. Bam. Same thing on the other side. Bambo. Okay. And you just tuck that in just a little bit. Man, this looks really stringy. I think it's the light I've got on here right now. All right, so you just want these even kind of barbells going on here. Once you got that, you're all set. We'll juice it up and have a vape off of her. All right, guys, that's the build. I struggled with it a little bit, but 22 gauge Canthal is pretty tough to work with. Make sure you have good manual dexterity and some strength in your hands to ream on that wire, because it is pretty tough. This is what it looks like all wicked up and ready to go. It is a bit of a struggle to get it going, but the hit off of it is super, super hard. All right, I'm gonna have a pull off this and show you how she vapes. Remember, guys, if you like the videos, like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. It's Maestro Vapes. Let's check it out. Got the copper cap that I got from Rona Hardware. Drilled it out with about 16 mils of air holes, I believe. It almost doesn't like to fit on my Patriot, but it does. All right, here it is. You can get some good vapes, short pulls off of it. It's pretty warm, it's a nice vape. All right, guys, like I always say, butt out, vape up, and breathe easy. Know your limits and vape within it. You're gonna have yourself a stellar day.